Welcome everybody. It's already the last Sunday before Christmas in 2020. So this is for everybody who now wants to celebrate a virtual Christmas. Today we can actually light all four candles. Last week we had the problem that the fire was spilling over from one candle to the other, so this will not happen today because all the greenery down here is unburnable. So enjoy this, briefly looking at the oxygen. Yeah, it looks like a crone growing. This is not a good word this year. So again, the red is the oxygen. The blue is the exhaust. And this is of course a two-dimensional, these are two-dimensional candles. So this is why they get rid of all the oxygen in between here. Okay, too much interested in science. Oops. Now this has been blown out by itself. Okay, due to the heat that is now everywhere, it easily returns to the fire. So for those of you who've not joined this before, this is of course simulated with the Lattice-Boltzmann method. There's an Arrhenius law for the temperature, for the pyrolysis, and also for the reaction between the pyrolysis product, which we can actually see here, which is not a lot as you see. And the oxygen, which we can see here, depending on the temperature, which we can see here. And this, all of this together gives us the flame, which is the, which is of course the glowing fuel. So it's calculated from the temperature and the fuel. And in this, the fuel will actually not run out. So there is an infinite reserve of fuel in this. Yeah. So next year I should simulate the melting wax, that it becomes a little bit more realistic. But this is what we have this here. Most of this has been implemented by my previous PhD student, Stefan Lenz. the reason why the flames deform that much is because there's movement down. So this is the velocity. Okay, you see there are two big vortices. Yeah, looks like they're actually ice, and the flow goes down in between these two vortices. And this happens, of course, because it's a two-dimensional flow. Back to our flames. Okay, on Christmas, I will try to light up a Christmas tree, which I still have to design. Actually, what we have not seen previously so well is that flames are actually hollow. It's only the outer part that is glowing, and in two-dimensional flames you can sometimes see that they are actually hollow. Like here. So, the vortices have been splitting up. So there is not so much oxygen anymore, but oxygen comes in to the domain from the left and the right hand side. So it won't go out. Probably the temperature, yes, the temperature has been increasing, so it's rather hot in there. And this is also the reason why it's burning while there is actually not so much oxygen left. Yeah, our oxygen. Okay, thank you that you were watching that far. Yeah, I wish you a nice Christmas and stay safe. Yeah, keep away from the virus, and I hope next year we'll have the usual Christmas celebration again. All the best.